1997. He was already there. I am not sure when he joined, but Biru knows. But the Pikas are knows. Anyway, must be before that.
85.
So he was already a veteran at Shah Institute at that time. And then the rest of the time we were together, and in fact we were not only in the same department. In the last about 1 or 2 years, we were roughly speaking in the same room. I mean, the room was divided by a partition, but the partition was thin, and through the partition I could hear that Anjanda's computer was crashing every day, and he was cursing the computer, and then he was calling our computer expert, and when the computer expert comes, his frantic description of what happened, the computer expert would ask, you know, what happened here? I don't know, the thing just started dancing on the screen. And he said, okay, but what did you do to make them dance? And nothing. I was just pressing some keys, but maybe I was doing them too fast or too slow. The computer got irritated. And so it was like that. It was a completely, I would say, enjoyable. I don't know, he was not enjoying, whether he was enjoying the series of events. But anyway, so we were in the room also together. But the most important memory about Anjanda to me, well, before then, I should say that as far as our research interests are concerned, we didn't have much in common. We were both in physics, of course, but that's hardly called common research interest. I did work on particle physics, and he did work on, you have heard already, he did work on mathematical models, exactly solvable mathematical models. So we didn't have exactly much physics to discuss between us, but he would often come and say that there is some very interesting identity that he has found and would try to describe them to me, or some very interested probability paradox that he has read somewhere, and he would come and describe it to me. And so these were very enjoyable, and I enjoyed them very much. But the most important part of my memory about Anjanda is for some time, he became the head of our division. I worked in the theory division, and when one of our previous heads retired, then Anjanda became the head. And he had enormous amount of ideas about what to do as the head of the division. I mean, I would say that, too many. So, first he would say that, okay, from now on we should have not only a faculty meeting, but we should have a division meeting. So in the division meeting, not only the faculty, but also the students, and also the clerical staff, and everybody would be present. And what will happen in that meeting, Anjanda? What will be discussed in that meeting? Oh, I haven't thought about that. Okay, let me think about it. I mean, when there is a faculty meeting, we know what to discuss. We talk about research, we talk about grants, and so on and so forth. And that is hardly something that you discuss in this audience. Yeah, I haven't thought. So then he thought about something that he would, first of all, he would find out, he would have one meeting every month. Then he would find out whose birthdays happened on that month. And then he would have something for that person or group of persons. Usually there will be more than one person in a given month. And then something will happen, and then there will be some cultural function and some lecture. And anytime there is a lecture, I don't know how it happens. You have seen it also happen here. Anytime there is a lecture, I am pulled in. I did not come here to give any lecture or to talk at all. So the first time this happened, Anjana said, "You will have to give a lecture." I said, "On what?" He said, "Oh, you can think." So I said, okay, I mean, this is the audience, so it will be, I mean, I cannot possibly give you physics lecture. I mean, there will be students, of course, but there will also be the staff and so on. The physics lecture would not be appropriate. So then he said, yes, but you can think of many other lectures which will be related to physics but will not be physics lecture. So, I mean, he had all these ideas which, I mean, he was so excited about the ideas that sometimes he didn't have the patience of mind to complete the ideas. So the ideas were thrown and there were others to implement the ideas. So actually, in that first meeting, I gave a talk, I still remember. I gave a talk on what are the things which are named after scientists. I don't know whether I called it this, probably I did not. But there I discussed that, you know, there are of course units, Newton and Joule and this thing, these are units which are named after scientists. But that's not what I'm going to talk about. What I'm going to talk about, you know, like streets in a city named after scientists. Yes, there are some streets named after scientists. But is there a city named after scientists? No, there is no city named after scientists. There are cities or areas of a city which are named after even small politicians. But after scientists? No university is named after a scientist in our country at least. So I talked about it and he was very happy. So, see, I told you, you can do it. So it was like this. And then I also remember a very passionate discussion between him and me. Near the end, I mean, somebody mentioned, I think Indraniti mentioned that he got interested in tsunami modeling. And so he thought that he would set up a lab which would be housed in the roof of Shaha Institute.
Hoping Open National University.
Yeah, I thought it would be called an open university because it's on the open roof. Yes, so he had some ideas. And then I told him, you have done this thing all your life. I mean, you have done mathematical models, Do you have any idea of how we would conduct such a huge experiment? I mean, huge means not CERN huge. But, I mean, he had the idea of having a 150-meter long water cistern or something like that, right? So, do you know how to make a 150? I mean, what would make? I mean, I know you will not make it. But out of which material you will make a 150-meter long cistern, do you have any idea? So, what kind of money is needed? What kind of manpower is needed? How will you estimate these things? And he was very enthusiastic. And somehow I thought that he didn't really think it over. I mean, his enthusiasm was great. I mean, this is really beautiful to see somebody so enthusiastic. But I had to tell him that just enthusiasm is not enough. You should also think about. And also he was listening to me and so on. I don't know. The project actually never got on its feet. But that may be because he became unwell and he couldn't do all the things in the same way that he wanted to do them. He didn't show it very much. Whenever he was around, he looked like the same person all around. Even, I remember it was a December of, which year, Shandukta?
When?
2016, that's what I thought, but I just wanted to make sure. December of 2016, and in the middle of December, he came to my office. I mean, as I said, it's the same office, except just divided by partition. He just opened the door of my office, and I said that I'm going away for a few days, and I will see you in the new year. So he actually never came back in the new year. We heard the news that he will not come back. But whenever he used to even leave for the weekend, he'd just not knock on my door just Friday afternoon evening. He would knock on my door and would say, probably he was saying, have a nice weekend. But he was saying in languages that I do not understand. He would say it either in Russian or in German, languages that he knew. And I would also reply it in languages that he did not. So it was a very beautiful way of not communicating between two persons. You just talk in one language and he just talk in. And one day I asked him, do you really say that have a good weekend? Or do you really, or what do you rather say? It will be nice that I won't see you for 2 days now. So he smiled. He always had the smile on his face, which is the best quality of him, which we will remember him by.